style of this next piece, the genre is loosely kind of classified as post-minimalist. And what that means is that you have a really limited amount of musical material or elements at play that change over a slow amount of time, kind of like a really nice soup that you might marinate all day long that starts to change ever so slightly. And in this, we have five polyrhythms that make up the entirety of the rhythms you'll hear that happens to unwind harmonically in a really beautiful and peaceful way. So here is unwind. Thank you. virtuosic and fun drum duo called Earth Moves. And you're going to hear a lot of fast interlocking rhythms and a variety of different textures on the different drums and instruments. The composer, Alexander Gardner, takes a lot of influence from the interplay, the repetition, and the melodicism of Japanese taiko drumming, which helped to form this work. So here's Earth Moves. experimental artist Marcel Duchamp in New York City had an idea, and that idea was to take a urinal, a porcelain urinal, and place it on the wall of an art gallery. And he called his piece Fountain. This jump-started an entire movement in art using found objects. In about 1930, John Cage, the infamous composer, took that idea of found objects in visual art and decided to put that in music. And so he composed often for tin cans, for car brake drums, and the like. Percussion has the great fortune of being able to use traditional instruments, most of what you see back there, and found objects that make really delightful sounds. And so this next piece is called Spoons, aptly titled by Jerry Sutt. And in Spoons, you really hear this beautiful, resonating, almost gamelan-like tone out of these instruments that we normally try to, might think of as kind of clanky, but in the way that we've suspended them and played them, you'll actually find some really beautiful tones out of them. And this is sort of juxtaposed by an often swirling and chaotic manner of rhythms that you're about to hear. So here's Spoons. Globe, which is for two vibraphones and Glockenspiel. And the composer David Molk said in his program notes that essentially it is exploring the similarities and differences between said instruments. It has a pretty unique ending in that the performers will play with their fingers in a really delightful, soft, gossamer landing. So here is Glow. Marimba duet called Wooden Music. It's one of the classics of our percussion repertoire. It features a lot of different types of influences and sections within the piece that change on a dime. So you might hear at one moment a very lyrical chordal passage that changes to a jazz-influenced melody that changes yet until a driving, perhaps minimalist rhythm. And this changing of styles helps to keep things fresh as the piece moves its moves through its various cycles. So here is Wooden Music. Thank you. people. First of all, thank you to our students, and really I should say aspiring professionals who just bring their absolute best every day in how they work and when they work, and it is just an absolute privilege to get to help mentor each and every one of you. Next, we wouldn't really be able to do what we do without the support from our upper administration, namely Linda Klein, the director of the school Department of Music. Beyond that, a huge thank you goes to our audio engineer and all around MacGyver, John Franson, who you might have seen running back and forth to make sure that the live stream is set up just on the right. It's part of our space here today. He also worked to help us construct the instruments you see right here, our delightful plywood wooden box and wooden slats, which make up our last piece, a quartet called Sandbox. And it's by a very well-established composer for percussion and wind ensemble and a whole bunch of other things, Viet Kyung. And this piece comes from the playful nature of the work, of everyone working around the sandbox, and also the fact that they literally play sandpaper. And I've talked with the performers a little bit earlier today, and we tried to brainstorm and think of, you know, what other pieces do we know that use these combinations of sound? And we couldn't come up with anything. So I really think that this piece is delightfully unique in the sound choices and also just compositionally. It has a lot of virtuosic, hacketed rhythms and a lot of fun surprises ahead of you. So to close out our program, here is Sandbox.
Bye.
are the Bronco Percussion Group, so there you go. Fun part.
Yeah. It's kind of easy for me if I just take away my own stuff. It's just.